so bloated today, I can't even zip my pants up.
Me neither. I'm retaining so much water, I feel like I'm carrying an aquarium around in my pocket. Oh, well, hey, check this out.
What? I was at the health food store with Lily this weekend buying cruelty-free eyeliner, and I found this new herbal remedy.
Lady time. All natural, all herbal, stops your out-of-control ovulation rantings.
Hmm.
Thanks.
Try it out. Hey, is it me, or has the whole hatred thing between our two groups reached an all-time high? It seems like until recently, we stirred things up and they just followed our hideous examples.
Well, sis, I think today we should let the girls know that it's the dawning of a new era and call a total detente.
Yeah. You know, actually, I think that if we just got them all into one room and communicated, we could all be great friends. Don't you think?
God, we're out. Thanks, Brooke, you hog.
That's...
Twice will last the longest in this life, character or rock hard vibes. In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, maybe.
In The Scarlet Letter, the first book we're going to dive into this semester in Feminist Lit, the heroine of Hester Prynne is forced to wear a shameful A for adultery on her chest. Now, she's forced to do this because she refused to identify the father of the child she conceived out of wedlock.
Hey, Carm, I think you should sew a big L on your chest, you know, for loser.
Yes, Mary Cherry.
Mr. Bennett, do I have to sit next to her? She stinks.
No, you are the one who smells Mary Cherry, like roadkill.
Come on, guys, let's concentrate. As we dig into Hawthorne's book, I really want you to put yourselves into Hester's clogs. To me, this book is feminist and humanist because it's about eventual victory from shame, from the secrets that destroy us. I guess maybe I feel so passionately about this book because for years I lived in shame. But I'm glad to say I came out of the closet 5 years ago and I'm doing much better. Yeah.
Mr. Bennett, let me just say on the record that I love the gays.
Thanks, Mary Cherry. We love you too.
Okay.
Okay, guys, here's the lesson du jour. We are all of us Hesters to a certain degree, with festering secrets. And I think what this book ultimately teaches us is that the truth is the only real freedom. Okay, so what I want you to do is I want you to write down your deepest, darkest, most shameful secret. Don't sign your name. Put it in the envelope. We're gonna throw them away later. And as we read, I want you to imagine being held captive by that secret, as sadly so many of us are. And hopefully by the end of the book, a little bit of Hester will have rubbed off, and hopefully some of the shame.
Mr. Bennett said to throw these away, right? Get rid of the shame.
Right.
I hate this time of the month. I always break out.
Have you tried the new soap?
you guys. How was the new lit class?
You know, I've decided I really hate that Mary Cherry. What is she doing in a feminist studies class anyway? She should be in fashion studies, and her hair is too damn blonde.
Yeah, well, you know who I hate more? Nicole. Ever since I quit the Glamazon, she has been meaner to me than ever. I swear to God, one more insult, I'm gonna snap.
Ow. Oh, my God. Cramp. Cramp.
Here, hold. Breathe.
Breathe. I hate men.
Okay, I've got to start hanging out with guys at least 1 week a month.
Nick, are you tender?
Yes, like two rare lamb chops on a Spitfire grill.
What are you looking at? Huh? Huh?
Nothing, just existing.
Is that chocolate on your breath? Are you trying to humiliate me because you know I'm craving it? Answer me!
Nice. Very nice.
Listen, can I sit with you guys today? The gang I sit with, they're all simultaneously greeting Aunt Flo.
Why don't you say so earlier?
Yo, bro, we're like suffering ourselves.
Hey, did you guys know that in Indian cultures,
the chiefs would make all the women like live outside of teepees when their lady time came?
Good idea.
Oh, what was that, Sugar?
Oh, nothing, Brooke. It's a really nice vest you got on there.
What's up, Harrison? Why are you sitting over here?
Sam, it seems to me that the boys are afraid of us because we're menstruating, and thus, in their sexist little eyes, we couldn't possibly have a rational, calm lunch hour.
Well, then we're just gonna have to prove them wrong, right?
Yes, we will. Is that my bracelet?
Oh.
That's my bracelet, Sam. That's my favorite bracelet. My mother gave me that bracelet. You didn't ask me if you could wear that bracelet.
Dear Mother of God, please let this end.
Brooke, just chill out, okay? It was in the drawer. I put it on. It's no big deal.
No wonder you stole it. It is, after all, the exact same color of the hula skirt of your dreams. Right, Sammy? Uh-huh.
You read my diary?
Yep.
So much for boundaries, huh, Brooke? Unbelievable. Brooke, if you could make it with any of the Backstreet Boys, who would it be?
You had no right to rifle through my secrets.
What'd she do now?
Stole my diary.
She stole my diary.
Uh-huh.
Nice fur, Mary Cherry, you freak.
Yeah, little Lily. I'd be glad to stop wearing anally electrocuted mink if only you'd be so kind as to skin your legs and present them to me as a gift.
Yeah, speaking of grooming, Carmen, there's this new invention. It's called leave-in conditioner. Just a small dollop in your palm, rub it in. It's real simple, hon.
Good for you.
It's time to rumble!
Fine. 3 o'clock?
Parking lot!
You don't have the nerve, fur freak.
Oh, bring it on, Lily. Bring it on. I know Tapo.
We've been waiting for this date since the beginning. Huh, sister?
You know what, Brooke? I bet you fight like a girl.
Oh, you want a piece? Let's go!
Yeah, bring it on, Brooke!
Yeah, you go. Bring it on.
Let's go. Let's go.
Starburst.
Let's get you.
They're gonna kill each other.
Oh, my.